You know, we used to talk about the security gap between militaries fighting wars and police providing policing, the more traditional policing capability. And that in between was the security gap where no one really knew who did what. But that security gap has closed significantly because of what we're doing overseas. We're not fighting state-on-state conflicts anymore. Most of it is insurgency, asymmetric warfare, groups against groups, groups against governments, often within the one country. So the role that the police can play and the role that the military can play has very much morphed, and we've become a lot closer. And it's really a matter of identifying the best capability to address whatever it is the issue is.
I will certainly acknowledge that the military is typically not the low-cost provider of any service, but it has deeply embedded capacity to deliver humanitarian assistance, whether it's the military medical community or combat engineers, communications experts, people who work the reconnaissance piece. I mean, there's a whole broad swathe of individuals.
In the first days of an emergency, clearly having military there is better than having nothing there. And they do a great job in those circumstances. To enable them to get back to what they do well, you need the police to follow on behind and apply years of policing experience, which is similar, complementary, but distinguishable to the way the military do things. But looking to establish or re-establish a more complete justice system, which is the justice pipeline, which is policing at one end, moving into justice in courts. This then necessitates bringing in the sort of civilian elements, the legal community, judges, lawyers, the support staff to courts, following on to your correctional or prison type agencies as well.
It's a very difficult balance, I think, between what needs to be done immediately and what needs to be done over the long term. And they have to be done side by side. Security sector reform, for example, is a generational activity. Reconstituting a police, a military, a national security apparatus, a legal system, the judiciary, is not something that will happen overnight. And yet, there needs to be the provision of security today. There really has to be a balance. But I think in designing those immediate interventions, you have to take into account what the outcome will look like.
When police deploy on the ground a complex emergency, you'll usually find it's with a mandate to assist the host nation to rebuild its own police capability. And quite often, both Australia and New Zealand have done this a lot around the Pacific and around the region, where they will leave a presence long after the emergency's over to help rebuild, to help train, to mentor the local police in the re-establishment of a strong policing presence in that country.